Sean Jackson, candidate for West Palm City Commission. Jerry, I'll never forget you said to me one day in this parking garage, you said, "Do not trust Kim Mitchell." And nope, don't laugh and don't shake your head, because you know what? I don't have to come up here and make these things up. You said don't trust Kim because she can't be trusted. But you know what I've come to find is that you are the very person that cannot be trusted. Now, you ran, wait, because I, you know what, this is serious. And no, you know what, Jerry, and you ought not walk away when I'm talking to you, because just like every other constituent in here, I deserve the same respect. Because you ran your campaign for mayor on transparency and government efficiency, and almost a year later that you've been mayor, there has been nothing transparent and nothing efficient about this government and this municipality. But in fact, you've lied and said that you've put $10 million into the Northwest community. But you know what? If I can come down to this waterfront and see what $30 million looks like, then what the hell does $10 million look like in the Northwest community? Sylvia, you run around town, thoughtful leadership for West Palm Beach. But yet, you allow quietly to go under wraps and don't bring any awareness to the fact that there is an illegal group home being run on the corner of 30th and Spruce, owned by Colin Rayner and Raleigh Hill. That is supposed to be a registered bed and breakfast, and it's an illegal group home being run, but yet you run on the auspices of thoughtful leadership for West Palm Beach. And Bill, I'm on a roll tonight, because you know what? This is ridiculous. The only two people up here on this dais that are actually doing something and actually fighting for this, the residents in this city, are Commissioner Robinson and Commissioner Mitchell. The problem is that because it's only two of them out of five, and you've got Jerry sitting here as the ringleader, nothing can get done, because it's always the two of them that are undermined by the three of you. And Bill, how dare you have the audacity to call a resident who just happens to work for the Studstill family and complain about the fact that the Northwest debate was rigged? It wasn't rigged. If you cannot be man enough to take the heat and to take the truth as compared to the foolishness that you've put out to the residents of this city, then you know what? You ought not sit in that seat. So I'm saying this to all the residents this evening. Whether you vote for me or whether whoever you vote for, something has to be done to bring about real equality, real efficiency, and real transparency in this government. Because if not, then we're going to have the same foolishness that we've got coming from this dais right now. And two people can't do it by themselves.
Thank you, Mr.